Thank you so much. It's both a privilege and a pleasure to be here in this August gathering. I spent 27 years in the armed forces, in the service of the nation, so believe me, I've spent enough time on the government side. I understand the thrill, the challenges, as well as the sense of achievement that one gets to work on a scale that one gets to work when working in the government. I thank my colleague from the industry, Mr. Gaurav, for having set the context, because it makes my life much simpler. You know, in life you say how, what, who and when. He very nicely articulated on what, on how it needs to be done, and hence I will simply focus on what needs to be done. I think there are certain words that he used, and that's going to be the focus of my 15 minutes talk. It's about, you know, this whole thing about next-gen technology is nothing more than a buzzword. Today's technology will get outdated tomorrow. And tomorrow's technology will get outdated day after tomorrow. So this whole aspect of technology is a constant state of transition. The only constant that we experience is change. And the point here is that how adaptable and how agile are we to change? You know, there were very senior leaders from the public sector industry who spoke so well in the first session. And everybody talked about, you know, the need to be agile, the need to be able to compete in the current market scenario that is not easy. It's challenging. You have a dual responsibility in the public sector of working hand in hand with the government for the betterment of society and the country at large, and at the same time increasingly compete with the increasingly competitive, you know, private sector. It's no different in the world of technology, and in the world of security I would say you can just take the challenge and increase it by 10 times. One gentleman talked about a paperless office and saving the planet. A lot of organizations are increasingly moving towards a paperless environment. A lot needs to be done in our government sector, where we see reams and reams of papers. But as we move to a digital world, it's not a question of if, it's a question of when we become fully digitized. And this whole process of digitization has, sorry to say, it sounds politically incorrect, has got nothing to do with saving the world and saving trees. It's got more to do, will be forced upon, more to do with absolutely the sense of survival, about efficiency, about bringing transparency. And of course, you know, we would also end up saving the world and saving a lot of trees. But in this entire environment, IT security is no different. I don't want to use jargon. I want to keep it very simple. I have a very simple deck of about 4 or 5 slides, which I want to showcase to you as I progress my talk. I want to hit the nail on the head. I want to basically focus on what really we need to be doing as of today, rather than how we need to be doing. And we keep hearing about jargons like, you know, emerging threats, APTs, advanced persistent threats, so and so, you know, 0 days. These are terminologies which are not new, but they are a clear and present danger. They represent something which we really need to take cognizance of. The fact of the matter is that cyber threat, as we converge, as more and more of convergence takes place, more and more of our daily functions, our business operations converge into the field of IT, are coming into the digital space. Now we are talking about 5G. You know, so we are seeing more and more of our daily lives and business operations being dependent upon information technology. Our privacy, our entire life is in the digital. For many of us out here who are on the wrong side of 45 or 50, I'm sure we remember the hours we used to spend when just simply going to a bank for withdrawing money. we today barely go to our banks for quite a stretch. But then the negative impact of if something goes wrong and if our identity gets stolen can also have very far-reaching and negative consequences on our lives. And it's no different in business. There are businesses today which are highly dependent on being able to operate in the digital world. I just want to give you a snapshot of a small element of what we do at Bharti Airtel. This is the scale at which we operate. And this is not even the entire picture. I wouldn't like to dwell on too much of details and specifics, but I just want to share with you that we are amongst the top one of the largest telcos in the world. And this is the scale that we operate, and this is a snapshot of a part of our daily operations. The critical point I want to make is that increasingly, as we converge, as more of our operations become digitized, our surface area of cyber attack is increasing. We have more and more applications coming. Our dependence on the digital world to communicate with our partners, with our customers, is going up. It's an urgent business need, and hence our digital surface is increasing. And as our digital surface increases, our surface area for cyber attack is also increasing. So just to give you a sense, where in some cases organizations had an events per second count of 5,000, 7,000 or 10,000 EPS, which very roughly gives a sense of the scale of their security operations, that has gone up by 3 times, that has gone up by 4 times. How do you humanly manage such an increase in workload? Today, it is simply not possible to do a proactive monitoring and protection of a large organization purely on manual means. And when I say manual means, you can have a SIM. The gentleman talked about the SOC. The traditional SOCs, at the core of that is a SIM, a security incident and events management tool. You have an army of people sitting out there. They look at events. They classify, identify, classify. Enter it into a ticketing tool, the alerts go out, incident responders have to then start taking actions, highly manual stuff. So manual stuff, manual activities can no longer actually protect you. What you end up getting is a false sense of security. You have spent a lot of money, you have a security operations center, you have an army of people, maybe still not sufficient, laid out there, and you get a sense of security that I have spent a lot of money, I have deployed a large number of people, I have engaged a services firm to do this for me. But unfortunately, the sad truth is that you are far from safe. So what we have done in Airtel, and we have set up a next-gen state-of-the-art SOC, we have really carried out a disruption. We joined hands with a Silicon Valley firm, which one should be proud is a startup by an Indian. It's about 5 or 6 years old, and they have a major development facility here in Varanasi. So it also qualifies for Make in India. Unlike a traditional platform, it actually has all the components which are critical to automating a substantial portion of your operations. So a typical SOC and a traditional solution, and I don't want to name any vendors here, would have a SIM component, would have threat intelligence, and would have user behavior analytics. What it doesn't have is it doesn't have orchestration, it doesn't have correlation, it doesn't have a SOAR function, which is security, orchestration, automation, and ranging, response. Typically, the MDR function is missing. So, if you have to carry out any automation, it doesn't have analytics and machine learning capability as well. So, if you have to really carry out automation in the strictest sense, then you have to buy a SOAR tool separately. You have to buy a platform which enables you to do analytics and machine learning separately. It not only increases your cost, it increases your complexity, and hence increases your journey and your cycle towards achieving optimum and next-gen security operations, which are largely automated. Any new, if we were to define a so-called, and if I may loosely use the term, a next-gen solution, we'll have to have these components. And it has to have these components. Because if it doesn't have these components, you're buying an array of products and basically spending a lot of time, effort, money, resources in system integration, which at times doesn't give you the necessary results. Please also understand that there is a huge problem with respect to availability of resources also. And it's not just here, and that's a real challenge. Our philosophy is, if something is not good for us, it's not good for our customers. So we don't take anything to the market which we don't consume ourselves. And this is something, this particular journey that I was talking about is something that we have already not only commenced, but completed to a very large extent. So let me articulate on what is it, this so-called term automation. A typical cycle would involve an analyst, an L1 or an L2, and the reality is it'll more or less be an L1, a person with maybe 2 years or even lesser experience, sitting out there and analyzing the SOC dashboard. He will witness an incident. He will detect it, identify it, classify it, and manually end up going and doing the needful on a ticketing tool. And thereafter, you're depending upon your incident response team to take whatever action. And let me give you a very simple example. The first thing that happens in any compromise, in most of the cases, is credential theft. Either the compromise of an email ID, and today we basically work on emails. We have very sensitive information which lies on official emails. If we witness any misuse of credentials, it could be on account of misuse, where somebody like me has shared my user ID with a third person in the company for not accessing email, but perhaps accessing something on an online portal, internally or externally. Or my credentials could have been stolen. The fact of the matter is, if I have my IT security infrastructure right, then I should be able to identify that there is a possible misuse or an attempt to use credentials, official credentials, by a different person. Now, once this gets detected, in a manual process, it may take a couple of hours, if at least not 24 hours. It doesn't take 24 hours for information to leak out. So if a credential misuse has been detected, it's a solid use case. It should be automatically detected, automatically classified, automated ticketing, and automated disabling of this from your AD at the other end. This should not take more than a couple of seconds. That is the advantage that you get through automation. And I'm not saying that you can achieve 100% automation of security operations as of today. But you can substantially increase the amount of automation that you can achieve in security operations. Anything which is a fixed input, a fixed output, and you know that it's a very predictable incident response, is a perfect case for automation. And a very large number of incidents which happen in our security operations are ideal cases for automation. Just to give you a sense for In the case of one organization, or if I may use the term customer, we analyze this. We analyze that 73% of the incidents happen to result in some activity on the firewall. You know, it's a company, this thing, so VPN, incidents related to VPN, 8%, end users, 6%, security, anything other than these tagged as general security events, 8%. Now, imagine if you deploy a tool like a TUFIN or an AlgoSec at the other end, you can even automate actions at the firewall. So you can bring in a phenomenal amount of automation and hence agility and improvement in your security operations by addressing and creating an architecture like this. I have just given an example. I'm not advocating the use of a particular technology or the other. We ourselves internally use some of these. But there are a multitude of solutions. So it's important to have SOAR function in your SOC solution. It's important to have a ticketing tool. We actually finished our integration of our SOC and our ticketing in less than 20 days. So if you have already done your homework, it's not such a big task. As long as you have the right building blocks, you can make this very stable architecture. So, as I said, I would just focus on ladies and gentlemen, it is not sustainable. You have to move. You have to bring in automation. It can only be done in phases, and the time to act is actually now, and we can actually help you with that. Thank you so much.